Alright, I thought I'd take a little break from the submachine videos I've been uploading to discuss Llama Adventure, a game which is almost exactly 10 years old. It came out May 15th, 2009. And I think I'll upload this on that day in order to, have it be exactly 10 years old when I upload this. And, across the sites I looked at, it has a combined total of about 900,000 plays, so it's pretty good. I've played it myself a few times, so I probably contributed about 850,000 of those 900,000 plays. When I made my Discord bot, I For one of the first games I added a sort of clone of Llama Adventure that you could play with the bot. But here's the original game, and it's crazy to think it's 10 years old now, because I remember when this came out, and this was brand new. So yeah, let's just start. And one of the things I love about this game is just how aesthetic the coloring is for words. And you can give that. Hello, you. I am so glad they finally shipped you here. I spot a bother with the street address, but that was fixed, I assure you. Aside from that, what's your name? Mocha. Oh ho, Mocha, such a ghastly thing to call yourself. I will call you Llama. You are Llama, right? Well, we're not, but. Oh, okay. Cheeky llama. You know what you are, and I do too. Got some humor, we do. Well then, llama, we're gonna start right away. If you'd open the door, we can start. You can do that by typing that into your magical button board, or you can look around first. Always look around in every room. Well, we can just open door and go. And there we go. Here's where we start our first experiment, Llama. I have made you 7 rooms fit for llama exploration and triumph. Do you understand? Yeah, I think I understand. Good llama. Obeying is key to survival. Now, as the 44th creature to enter this facility, your job is to get past room 7. Each room has a simple puzzle to be solved. If you solve the puzzle, the next room will open. If you fail the puzzle, then you will most certainly die a terrible death. But that is all semantics and nothing to worry about. Is that clear? Yep. Fantastic. If you need help at any time, feel free to use that command. I'll be looking at you funny behind that mirrored one-way glass that all test facilities of this nature have. Feel free to look around you. Always look at everything. It will help you last longer than the others. All right, well, we will look around. Let's see. All right, right here is a table I bought from the neighbors during a garage sale. Across the room is a similar door to the one you just passed through, this time with a lock. Well, let's look at the table. On my table is a white cloth with 3 keys: a bad key, a tasty key, and a good key. Read note. Crap. Look note. There we go. The bad key is good and the good key is bad. The bad key can kin you through the door. That tasty key, you can eat that. It's made of alfalfa. Oh, well, I'll just eat tasty key. Oh, and I need to pick up tasty key and eat tasty key. And now I had a delicious snack. But now to get out of the room, we need to do pick up bad key. Look door. Use bad key on the lock. Open door. And go. Yes. Now that we have met in person, I'm going to be typing you on this monitor located in each room. I'm not sure if the sex is coming through. Can you see it? Yes. Good llama. Obeying is key to survival. I quite admire your ability to get through a simple room like that, but can you get through a simple room such as this one? I'm tickled by the idea that you can win such an easy room as the last one, but you cannot win an even easier room such as this one. All you have to do is stop that clock between after it takes 14 to 15 seconds. Do you understand? Yes. Fair enough. Well, we will have to look around for this clock. Yes, clock. Okay. There's a hammer. So we will pick up clock, use clock on indentation, and then pick up hammer, use hammer on clock, and we will do this between 14 and 15 seconds. 12, 13, 14. And there we go. And it's unlocked. So we will open door and we will go to room 3. My favorite food? Let's say it is tacos. That's a terrible choice. I personally know that tacos is, as you kids put it these days, made of lose. Do you know what lose tastes like? Disgusting. I would rather ravish a bowl of casserole. That is your new favorite food, llama. I've prepared a third challenge here. It is preposterous to think you'd beat this level, but I set it up anyway, just in case. Do you think you can beat it? Yes, I can. Good for you. I admire your good attitude. I didn't know llamas could have such good attitudes. I've built you a llama computer. I call it the Llama computer for this challenge. For this challenge will be simple. Just beat the computer game and you get to continue your quest towards the end. Fail, and the entire room will fill with an amazing fire from the vent above you. If you use the computer, just say what you want and I'll do the magic for you. Understand? Yes. All right, let's use the computer. And we are using an Apple II. Well, we don't want to die. We don't want to exit. Let's go to game. First question. What is my first question? What is my first question? What is my first question's answer? What is my first question? So spell it right, yes. What is my first question's preceding question's answer? It will also be the answer to the next question. What is my first question? All right, and said it's going to be the next question's answer. So, what is my first question? And if the answer to the previous question was the answer to the first question, then which it was, then this question will be the same. What is my first question? Name of Quincy Stanley, wasn't it Buggles? Yes, Buggles. Ooh, I don't know. Misspell that. And we will 4 exit. And we will open door. And go to room number 4. Okay, llama, evil llama, stupid llama. Excuse me, I'm just a bit frustrated. Not many of my llamas are making it past room 3. Where are my manners? This room 4 is a pit of death. Can you feel the warmth? It's lovely. Take a look around, llama. Good luck. All right, well, let's look around. There's indeed a pit of death. I actually do not remember this level. I remember the previous levels, but I don't remember this one. Pit is a lunchbox. Can I open lunchbox? Okay, I have to pick up lunchbox and open lunchbox. Okay, so I can't use that. So we'll drop it. And what was around me again? All right. What if I look at bridge? All right. And oh boy. Okay, that's a very large block of text. If I just go over it, I'll probably die. But let's try anyway. Can I go bridge? Now what if I look around? Can I open door? Oh, okay. It was unlocked all along. That might be why I don't remember it then. Oh boy. Do you drive llama? Well, I'm a llama, so I don't drive. Yes. Yeah, having interactions with the postman, yes. That's very good. Yes, I enjoy these games we're playing. I think I'm excellent at solving these puzzles. Would you rather be grazing in a field? Nah, I'd rather be solving these puzzles. How many llamas would you guess died in this strange apparatus of rooms already? 100. Oh, wait. 100. Why is that pink? 2, 3, 4. Interesting. I don't think I've ever noticed that before. Anyways, let's get a handle on ourselves. Here's the next room. Good luck. Let's look around. Let's see. Okay, there's a sofa and a TV. Under the TV is a VCR. Okay, so I need to look clock, and it reads 10:29, which intriguingly is almost the actual time it is now. You can see it's 10:53 right now. Right, 10:29, hopefully it stays that way. Look sofa, because I think we need a remote. Look cushion. Pick up cushion. And okay, so drop cushion, pick up remote. All right. Look remote. Okay. Wait, can I say set? Enter, interesting. Use remote. Okay, push set. Push one, because it's 10:29. Push zero. Push two. Push nine. And wait, was there any other button? Okay. Can I open door now? Huh. Okay. Push. Do I have to push set again? Okay, maybe not. Push one. push 0, push 2, push 9, and drop remote, look VCR, look, it was 1029, right? Yeah, okay. Look TV, television. Huh. Look for Mo. Oh, enter. Okay, wait. So I do push enter. Oh, I can't push buttons without having a remote, but yet somehow I push the button without having the remote. Well, I'll open the door and go. I actually never knew you could do that without the remote. That's very interesting. Alright, welcome to Room 6, Llama. This is the point where I say, well, well done. I guess you deserve some sort of compliment. So far, experiment is a rousing success, but I bet you didn't even know. You deserve something, perhaps some casserole. I know that's your favorite food. I've prepared a 6th challenge here. It is preposterous to think you'd beat this level. You've got one more after this one, but you probably won't beat this one, so don't worry. But I set it up anyway, just in case. Do you think you can beat it? Yep, we're pretty confident. Alright, let's look around. And let's see. Okay. There's a crank, a ball, and rope. Ooh, okay. Tie. Okay, so tie is a word. Can I do tie, rope, crank? Pick up rope, tie, rope, crank. Look, crank, tie, rope, hook, tie, rope, dog. And then drop rope, pick up ball, and throw ball. Cindy has her ball now, so go ahead and take off. Go? Oh, I don't even need to open up a door. Okay, last room. Yes, it is quite crazy. Alright, regardless, I think we've come to a rather interesting conclusion here. You are by far the smartest llama I have ever come across. And typically, the other llamas would find a way to die before reaching this point, yet you are here. Standing before me in this last room with only entrance and exit door and one double-paned piece of glass that I can see into, but you cannot see me. You can't see me, right? Yes. Oh, are you agreeing with the statement or the fact? I'm not sure. Shucks. Well, either way, I applaud your victory, llama. Alas, your journey is over. How does that make you feel? Yes. Is that so? Well, I think about the same too. I guess I no longer need to involve these crazy experiments anymore. However, there's one more task I need you to perform. It's just a small one. Do you plan on continuing? Yes. That's the spirit. I've built a program on my computer that you'll need to play through. If you would, just use the keyboard over there. Once you complete this program, the exit door will open. What do you think's behind that door? Probably some casserole. Or perhaps... No, I'm wrong. It's a green pasture of freedom, a world to explore, and the life of a llama to lead. You'll be on your own, away from the death and discouragement of a terrible place like this. You'll go far beyond the realms in which this place constrains you. It's your life, llama. Do you want that? Yes. Spirit or emotion. Your life is about to unfold. Just use that keyboard, and we can get ready for the final challenge. However, if you use the keyboard... Good luck. I call it Llama Adventure. Enjoy. No, we're all the way back at the beginning. There's no actual end to the game. It just loops over and over and over again. So that's most of Llama Adventure. There are a couple Easter eggs. I don't know all of them off the top of my head, but I know... was it Muffin? I think Muffin. Nope. Mr. Rubik's? Rubik's. Rubik's. Okay, well, I can do this. I'm sure that's. Oh, wow, really? There are Easter eggs, but I forget which ones, what you have to do to get them to show up. Anyways, let's look at the credits. And it was programmed and written by JMTBO2, tested by Joey and Dan, copyright Armor Games 2009. Was it Joey? No. Might be Armor. I'll just try this. Nope. All right. So I guess I'm not gonna find it. But yeah, that's Llama Adventure. I hope you enjoy that.